Oh, hi guys. 1 second. All right, grade two writers, how are you doing today? I hope you're doing well. All right, first things first. Welcome to another writing workshop with me, Mr. James. Okay, let's kick off with the joke of the day. So hold on to your ribs again. What did the nose say to the finger? Stop picking on me. Yes, no. Suit yourself. All right, and shout outs. Today's shout outs. Who's done good work on Seesaw in the last few days? Okay, Miriam, really like your lunch menu. Blake, Ben the dog story was good. Arman, your favorite dessert. I like reading about that. Eneko, your scary story about a vampire. Good. And also I want to give a big shout out to everyone who's done a presentation for the writing celebration in a few days. So well done to you guys. All right, what are we doing today? So we're going to move on to a new unit now. And we're going to circle back to a unit we did at the beginning of the year, the narrative writing unit. So by now you're much better writers than you were. You know how to add details. You know how to write much more descriptive stories and other kinds of writing. So today, we're going to look at this. Good writers plan their characters and settings so readers can visualize settings and connect with their characters. Okay? So, you should all remember the story mountain. Okay? The beginning, middle, end, and lots that happens in the middle. I'm gonna go into the middle and the end in future writing workshops. But for the moment, for today, we're just gonna concentrate on characters and the setting. Okay. All right, so my character. All right, so I had a bit of a think about what kind of character I'd like to write about. And I had some ideas. These are some of the ones I kind of tossed away. I had a main character called Robbie the Eraser, and he was scared of people using him in case he's erased from existence. All right, so you don't have to use people, you can use animals or objects or anything, bring it to life. My other one was about a robot, it was called Felix, the forgetful robot, who always turned himself off, but he always forgot to turn himself on again. I had another one called Ray the X-Ray Kid, who could see into everyone's bodies. He had X-ray vision. He could see into everyone's bodies, but he just got very squeamish all the time. And Ivan the Invisible Schoolboy was another character I thought of, but I couldn't draw him because he's invisible. Alright, anyway, but I came across one because I got really sick of writing about penguins, all right? I didn't want to write anything about more penguins. You know what it's like. You were probably the same. You'd written all your information, your facts, and your added details about your topic. You didn't want to write any more about it. But I kept going back to my penguin on the front cover of my information booklet, and I thought, oh, what if he had like a bow tie? It kind of looked like he was wearing a tuxedo, kind of like a James Bond character. And I thought, what if he could be like a private detective? So that got me thinking. So I created a character, and his name is Pablo Penguin, PI. That's PI, Private Investigator. And as you can see, he's got his sunglasses on. He's a bit of a cool character. He's wearing a bow tie. He's got his magnifying glass there to look for clues. He's drinking a seawater martini. Okay, so first thing to do when you have a character, you need to describe them. So as I'm sure you remember from earlier in the year, you've got outside traits and inside traits. Now, what are some of the outside traits of Pablo Penguin PI? Well, you can see them already just by looking at the picture. So he's got sunglasses. He's got a bow tie, magnifying glass, and what else? What else has he got? He's quite tall. Tall for a penguin. And he's quite handsome. He's handsome amongst the penguin community. Okay, so those are his outside traits. Now, how about inside? Inside's really where you see his personality and his true character. What's he like as a person? Well, he's a private investigator, so I'm going to say he's cool and calm. Nothing much riles him. He doesn't really get nervous very, very often. He's clearly intelligent. He's a risk taker. Sometimes he needs to do things that may get him in trouble or may get him hurt, but he doesn't mind taking those risks to reach his goal and to find out things he needs to find out to solve whatever problem it is. Okay, he's very he's well spoken. Yes, indeed. The name is Penguin, Pablo Penguin. And also, I've thrown in he's trained in martial arts. I'm gonna say mixed martial arts. He's trained in MMA, all right? So those are his inside characteristics. Pablo Penguin, PI. Now, we have a character. How about a setting? So usually the character and the setting is are linked. So Pablo's setting is on a beach. He lives on a beach. And I thought back to a beach I'd been to in South Africa called Boulder Beach, where you can go and see penguins and be around penguins. There's loads of them there. And I thought I'd just sketch my setting first. You can see you've got the oceans, you've got the boulders around. It's very busy. You've got the bushes at the back, and there's this hill's going back from the beach. And here you have a cave. So that's going to be my setting. That's going to be where he lives day to day. Pablo Penguin, PI. So I'm just going to write down some of the adjectives I can use to describe the setting. Okay. So it's quite crowded. It's crowded. It's noisy because there's lots of other penguins around, and also tourists as well. Lots of tourists around. There's crashing waves. There's green bushes and hills. And there's golden sand. And clear water. So that's how I've described my setting. You can have more than one setting. Obviously, Pablo Penguin PI, he may go to different settings around the world. Who knows? But just to begin with, for the start of the story, we've described my main character and also the setting. All right, so your task for today is to come up with your own character for a story. Draw a little picture. Talk about his or her, or their outside traits and their inside traits, and also to describe the setting. The first setting that you will come across when reading or writing the story. Okay? All right, so that's all from me for the moment. Best of luck. I'll say goodbye and keep washing your hands.